Sriyukta D.K. Roy, who is presiding over today's function, our Honorable Minister and my elder colleague in the Cabinet, Dr. Damodar Raut, the Health Minister of the State, Dr. Mahapatra, who Dr. Raut has already described as a pride for our state, who is known all over the country as one of the best neurosurgeons of India. And now we are all happy and we are proud that we have got him at the first director of AIIMS Bhubaneswar. And Sriyukta Bhagat ji, my dear students and friends, after listening to this very knowledgeable and valuable speeches of the four of the personalities sitting on the dais, I don't feel like delivering a very long speech. I'm not capable of doing that. I was asking Dr. Damodar Raut, he's my elder colleague in the Cabinet, and who has taken over the Health Department after I was, what should I say, removed. And as all of us know, the one of the most experienced, not only politician of our state, but an experienced administrator of our state, who has been working as a minister under different chief ministers, starting from Biju Patnaik, I think Nalamani Raut Rai, and now Sri Naveen Patnaik ji. I am not that much of an experienced politician. And he delivered a very emotional speech. I have seldom heard the speech of Dr. Raut as I heard it today. He's a very blunt personality. He all the time speaks what he means. And that time, that sometimes hurts many people, including me. I would, at the outset, I would like to convey my, I would like to beg apology before Mr. Bhagat noted. Because when I took over as the Health Minister of the state around 3 years and 4 months before, in 2009, I was introduced to Mr. Bhagat by the then Chief Secretary, if I correctly remember, Sri Ajit Tripathi, who has since retired. And he told me that, Mr. Acharya, Mr. Bhagat is initiating a very, very good thing for the health sector, which is going to help not only the people of Orissa, but whole of the country. And that is the newest concept of telemedicine. And he requested me to extend all sort of cooperation to Mr. Bhagat and his organization, the OTET. Mr. Bhagat has been initiating, working on this scheme, if I know correctly, since last couple of years. But I'm sorry to say that in spite of all my sincere effort, which Bhagat, Mr. Bhagat knows, when I was the health minister during my tenure, I could not materialize it. And I'm grateful to Dr. Damodar Raut that within 2.5 months of assuming the health ministry, health department, he has been able to roll it, this new program for the people of Orissa. So I regret that during my tenure I couldn't do it. And I thank and I compliment Mr. Dr. Damodar Raut that within a short span of 2 months, a capable leader like Dr. Damodar Raut could be able to roll this new program in the state, roll out it. So thanks, Dr. Raut. And Mr. Bhagat, who has been working very sincerely, as we know, whenever Mr. Bhagat speaks, he speaks of Bhagwan Satya Sai Baba. Around 2 months back, I went to Puttaparthi. Of course, Mr. Bhagat was with me. Rather, he dragged me to Puttaparthi. And we visited the hospital there. For the first time, I went to Puttaparthi. For the first time, I saw a hospital started by Bhagwan Satya Sai Baba. And when we alighted from the car, I thought it is a 5-star hotel. I couldn't conceive that it is a hospital. Because in my mind, Capital Hospital was there. Katak SCB was there. Burla Medical was there, full of dirt, full of crowd, full of indiscipline, full of panopico in different corner. So when I reached there, I asked Mr. Bhagat, it is a hospital, it is a star hotel. And I was amazed to see not a single bike or a car or a cycle in front of the hospital. Even not many people are wandering in front of the hospital. But when I entered into the hospital, I was astonished. It was buzzing with activities. Patients were there, relatives were there, doctors were there, paramedical staffs were there, and full silence was there. Full silence was there. So that was a hospital there. So when I saw the cleanliness of the hospital, I was impressed. I asked the fellow who was accompanying me and showing me around the hospital, how many cleaning staff you have? How many sweepers? Like we have in the SCB Medical College, hundreds and thousands. He said, not a single paid sweeper we have engaged in this hospital of Sri Satya Sai Baba. Not a single paid sweeper. All sweepers, all those people who clean this hospital are volunteers. So I picked up a volunteer. He was just Chattana Sapha Gurudhule, Antegiri. I said, gentlemen, who are you? He said, I am a retired chief engineer. A retired chief engineer of a state was working as a sweeper in the hospital of Satya Sai Baba in Puttaparthi. So I picked up another gentleman. Sir, who are you? I am a doctor. I was in the government service. I have retired. Now I am working here. Taramanyandinai. I am mentioning this point because where there is a sense of spiritualism, there is discipline. Where there is a sense of spiritualism, there is sense of dedication. When there is a sense of spiritualism, there is devotion. And where is devotion, there is God. Where there is dedication, there is God. Where there is sincerity, there is God. There is Satya Sai Baba. So because Mr. Bhagat is a great, great devotee of Bhagavan Sri Satya Sai Baba, and whatever he does, whatever he starts with a sense of spiritualism, with a feeling of spiritualism, with a sense of dedication. Therefore, I am 101% sure, though the scheme has been belated, this is going to be one of the most successful scheme in the health sector in our state of Orissa. I have absolutely no doubt in it. Let us see what is happening. But my sincere suggestion has been to Mr. Bhagat that that now, after much effort and much persuasion, he was moving from pillar to post in the government, moving to the minister, to the secretary, to the bureaucrats, to the clerks, koridiyantu, mokama koridiyantu, and you know how our system functions, not only our state, but in the whole of our country. And ultimately it happened. Now government has entered into an agreement with OTET. And this scheme has been rolled out on PPP mode, public-private partnership mode. OTED has been authorized by Dr. Damodar Rao and his department to utilize the government premises in the government building to start this telemedicine system. And as has already been explained by speakers, including Mr. Bhagat, we are going to get a number of benefits. As Dr. Mahapatra was and Dr. Rao was very, very, very loudly and clearly explaining, this concept of telemedicine is going to help us a maximum in a country like India and in a state like Orissa. As Dr. Rao was very rightly saying, there are still many pockets in the state where we have not been able to build a road after nearly 65 years of our independence. There are many rural pockets in our state, in Kalahandi district, in Koraput district, in Malkanagiri district, where people do not get clean drinking water even today. And therefore, the prevalence of waterborne diseases are much more in those areas. Every day report is coming, people are dying, people are suffering. And you know how Dr. Rai was very rightly describing the mindset of the young doctors today. I remember in my early days when I was a young boy in the school, we saw doctors riding in bicycle in mud roads and attending to patients in the remote villages, charging a very minimal fees of 2 rupees or 3 rupees. Comparatively, the road condition has improved. Comparatively, the villages are in a better position. But a boy from a village who has passed from the village primary school or the village high school, graduated somewhere in a nearby town, done his MBBS in Burla, Barampur or Medical College in Orissa, is not inclined to go and serve his own village. This has been the mindset, as Dr. Raut has been very correctly saying. So under these circumstances, when our motto has been to provide the basic healthcare facilities to the common man in the village, I think to overcome such hurdles and bottlenecks, telemedicine is the one of the best concept of the modern day. Who is voted, led by Dr. Bhagat, has been trying to implement with government association in our state. And if I am correct, this program, I think, I can't say whether it's the first time you are doing in Orissa, but my impression is we are very forcefully starting to do it in Orissa, in the whole of the country. Dr. Mahapatra can explain it better. And many benefit we are going to derive out of this program. In his literature, Mr. Bhagat has very, very correctly described it: supervision and consultation for primary care in remote sites where a physician is not available. A patient did not come to Cuttack for medical checkup. What happens sometime, from a remote village, a poor patient is advised by the village doctor to go to SMU Medical College, Cuttack, to get it checked up whether operation is required or not. He arranges fund, come to Cuttack SMU Medical College, stays somewhere. If no place is available, he sleeps his night in the veranda of the SMU Cuttack Medical College. Get an appointment with the doctor. After examining, the doctor says, go back to your village. Come after 3 months. If we take the help of telemedicine and a consultation with a doctor at SMU Medical College by a patient living in a remote village in Sambalpur district, did not come to Cuttack at once. He can take the advice over telemedicine, ask the doctor, that the doctor can see him, see the transmitted photograph, advise the patient what medicine to take, of course, through a local doctor, advise the patient whether he is required to come to SMU Medical College Cuttack overnight or he can delay it for 3 months. So accordingly, the patient can check out his own program. This is the one of the best benefit the telemedicine is going to provide to the poorest of the poor patient in our state, living in the remotest area of our state. And this benefit we can get from the system of telemedicine. Pre-surgical investigation and post-surgical follow-up management of chronic diseases. Reduction of out-of-pocket expenditure of rural people on healthcare medical facilities, as I said. The patient can cut his medical expenditure to a greater extent if telemedicine facilities are provided to the poor patient. Saving up manpower of rural people in scheduling appointments for hospital visits. Very vividly he has described. Regular screening at doorsteps of people at ₹2.50 per day per person for preventive health care. I do not know how much OTD is going to charge, but what I have been given to understand is the patient has to pay, I think, 40 rupees. And there is, again, concession on that. A mere 40 rupees or 30 rupees will be borne by the poor patient. He takes the medical assistance or advice from a doctor in a higher medical college through telemedicine system. If I am a poor patient in a village, I am required to come to Cuttack SMU Medical College or Barampur Medical College or Burla BSS Medical College. I have to spend a lot of money, few hundred rupees minimum I have to spend. But if I take the help of telemedicine, my medical expenditure cut considerably. This is the maximum benefit we are going to provide to a poor patient living in a remote village if we are able to provide telemedicine facilities to that village in our state. Mr. Bhagat has been authorized by the state government, if I have correctly understood, to start his telemedicine facilities in all the 314 blocks of 30 districts in our state. My humble submission to Mr. Bhagat has been, don't start it at a time. Don't expand your empire overnight. But Mr. Bhagat is so over-enthusiastic. He is planning to spread it to all over the state. But my humble submission has been to Mr. Bhagat that you first restrict it to certain pockets. You start it in certain pockets of the state, consolidate it there, see the result, then go to other places. So that it will be very systematic, it will be done in a very coordinated way. And another maximum benefit through medicine, which is being initiated on government support to OTAT organization, is Mr. Bhagat and OTAT is going to provide in a couple of years large number of employment opportunities to the young, educated people of Odisha in lakhs. As all of us know, there is an employment mission in our state. If I am correct, he has already given training to 800 young boys and girls. How to operate a blood pressure machine, how to test blood sugar of a common patient, etc., the common things. And he has been able to provide training, preliminary training of 2 months, 3 months, 4 months or 6 months to around 800, if I am correct, young boys and girls of the state. They can be well employed under this telemedicine system. He is arranging loan facilities from banks. The bank will provide loan to the young boy who will get a training, acquire some preliminary knowledge on telemedicine. He will be provided a loan by the banker. He will be provided a motorcycle. He will be provided some of the equipment that has been exhibited here. And he will apply his own training. So he is given employment. He will provide minimum medical facilities to the poor man in the village with the minimum expenditure. So we are expanding our healthcare system. We are trying to fulfill our ambition of providing the minimum health facilities to the poorest of the poor people in our state, staying in a remote area. And simultaneously, we are providing self-employment to the young men and women of our state. So it is a great, great work. I think if successfully implemented, OTAT will be doing for our state of Odisha. So I wish every success to this program. And I hope, as I said at the outset, because Mr. Bhagat and OTAT has always been inspired by a sense of spiritualism. And where there is a sense of spiritualism, as I said, there is dedication, there is sincerity, and there is devotion. And when there is dedication, where there is devotion, where there is sincerity, the omnipresent is there, the God is there, and the program is bound to be a successful program. I'm not going to deliver a very long speech. With these few words, I once again compliment OTAT for initiating this unique program in our state. And I hope with the fullest support of the people associated with this program, directly or indirectly, including those people who are working in the government, this program will be a very successful one. And I'm confident that it will be proper understanding, coordination and cooperation among the officials in the government who are associated in implementation of this program in the health department or other related department, and the functionaries of the OTAT, with their combined effort, cooperation, proper understanding and sincerity and dedication, this telemedicine program in Odisha is going to be a great, great success in the coming days. With these words, I once again compliment OTAT organization, Mr. Bhagat, all his associates who have been working since last couple of years, as I know, to implement this program. And over and above this program, if I know correctly, OTET is planning to work in some other sector also, and I hope and I pray the Almighty that let this program be a very, very successful program, and let it help a lot in boosting the primary healthcare system of our state. Thank you, everybody.